Hey, this is Max here, and in this tutorial we're going to talk about the if-else inside ActiveCampaign. It's like a really cool feature that you can use to make your automations way, way, way smarter. So in this tutorial I'm going to explain you what it is, how you can use it, and I'll show you a bunch of practical examples. So let's dive in. So first of all, what is the if-else? So the if-else is an action that you can use to split your automations based on if a contact is matching one or more conditions. And the if-else, the name already says it, is using if-else conditional logic. And this is something that you also use in everyday life. Like, if the street light is red, then you will wait, or else you will cross the street. And it also works like this inside your automations. Like, I'll show you in a bit how you can set that up. But you could, for example, check if the contact has this tag, then we follow this path and then we do this, or else we follow the no path and then we do that. So let me create you a little quick example. So when you create a new automation, you can click this thing to add an if else under conditions and workflow. So when you create that, then ActiveCampaign will ask you, how would you like to split this automation? So based on which conditions do you want to do that? So you can either select one condition, or you can create a bunch of different conditions, and you can even create a whole new segment group to compare one set of conditions to another set of conditions, but that's slightly more advanced. And so, for example, what I just said, if you want to check if someone has a certain tag, then you can just say, okay, tag, and then you can say, okay, I want to split this based on if this person has the tag or does not have the tag. So here, I, for example, want to check if someone purchased my product called Funnels That Convert, and I click add. So everybody who purchased it will have this tag, and then the person will follow the yes path. If not, then it will follow the no path, and then you can do something based on that. But you can really create all kinds of conditions. So you can, for example, can also check if someone is in a certain list, or you also can check if they entered an automation or not entered an automation, or ended an automation, or is currently in an automation, or maybe if their email address contains Gmail, for example. You can really check so many things. So really just play around with this and see what is possible. It's really crazy. You can even use where someone is coming from, for example, their country, if they're from Germany or the Netherlands or the United States or Mexico. You can also create automations based on that. So really, really lots of possibilities. So what I want to do is I want to show you some cool examples that I'm using that I think will give you like a good overview of what you could use it for. So first, I want to show you how you can resend an email if the email was not opened. So to do that, I created a little automation that's called the lead magnet delivery. So inside this automation, we deliver a cheat sheet as soon as someone requested that, maybe filled out a form or something. And then what I want to do is we want to resend that email if the person did not open it within 2 days. So how do we do that? So we send an email, and then you see here that we have a wait action. So inside the wait action, we check, okay, wait until this person has opened the email or click the link inside the email, because sometimes people block the tracking of that you can open an email, that then we simply do not see that. But we can always check if someone clicked the link, because ActiveCampaign is creating like these special links. And then we say we do that for up to 2 days. So as soon as someone during those 2 days opens this email, they will just continue right away. If not, then that person is going to wait in this wait action for 2 days. And then after that, you see that we have an if else. So in this if else, we basically check, okay, did this person open the email or clicked a link inside this email? If yes, we follow the yes path, and then you see that we do not resend the email. If not, so if the person did not open the email or did not click a link inside the email, then we send a resend of the first email. So that's basically just the same email with a different subject. And then we wait again until they open that. But if you want to learn more about the lead magnet, how you can deliver that, I also created a separate tutorial about that. But just to show you how you can like check if someone opened an email, yes or no. So to do this, it's important that before you do that, it's important to wait for at least 2 days. Like if you would check with an if else right away, then you do not give people enough time to open the email, obviously. Now, the next one that I want to show you is a little onboarding sequence. And inside this onboarding sequence, you will see that we have a welcome email. And this welcome email, we're only going to send to people who did not receive any other email yet. So it works like this. So people enter this automation when they subscribe to my main list and when they're also are not in this automation yet. And then we wait for 5 minutes. And that's basically to give people time to maybe enter or like receive any other email, maybe if they requested some kind of lead magnet. And then after those 5 minutes, we check, has been sent any campaign. So that basically means has been sent any campaign, any email inside an automation. If yes, we follow this path and then we use a go to action to skip the welcome email. So if this person has not been sent any emails, then we'll get an email that says you're in. Pretty cool, right? So I also created a separate tutorial about an onboarding sequence in case you want to do that. You see it in the iCard above, but that's pretty cool, right? So that's another cool example, I think. Now, then what you can also do is interest tagging based on which pages someone visited it. So let's go back over to automations and then I have to look up where I've been hiding that automation. It's probably on another page here. Here, interest tagging. So inside the interest tagging, we also use an if else to check if someone visited a certain page at least a certain amount of times. So you see in this if else, we check, does the contact match the following conditions? Visited a URL that contains ActiveCampaign at least 2 times. Because then I know this person is interested in ActiveCampaign. So how do you do that? So here we check, has visited URL that contains, you can also use exact if you want, contains ActiveCampaign. And then I do not want to do that when someone is ever was on the page that contains that or only 1 time. So I want to check at least 2 to 5 times at, and then if yes, the person gets a tag that says interest, topic, ActiveCampaign. And then we go to the next one where we also check, okay, is this person then in this case interested in ManyChat, or here is this person interested in automation? So that's another thing that you can use the if else for. The next example that I want to show you is that you can check if someone already entered a certain automation. So let me go back to the lead magnet delivery automation. Where is it? Here, the lead magnet delivery automation. Because in the end of that automation, maybe you already noticed it, we are adding people to an onboarding sequence. So to do that, we check with an if else, did this person already enter the automation onboarding new contacts? So if this person has ever entered the onboarding sequence, then the person will go here and then we just end the automation. If not, then we start our onboarding part and then we exit the automation. So this is also something that I really use often to check if someone was already inside a certain automation. And then also the next example that I want to show you is to create a master automation. And I think this is really truly amazing. It has saved me at least lots of time, because then you do not have to check at the end of every automation if someone already entered another automation. So that is to create, I call it the master automation handler. So when you create a funnel, you probably have a certain or like some specific steps that the person needs to go through before becoming a customer. So in this example, that is that we first want to onboard someone, then we want to invite them for a free course, then we want to add them to our evergreen newsletter, and then we want to do an evergreen promotion. So how does this work? So again, we use the if else like a lot. So first, this person will enter the automation when they join the main list. And then we check, does the contact match the following conditions? Has not entered the automation onboarding new contact. So not. So if this person did not get the onboarding sequence yet, basically, then we enter the automation and then we wait. We wait until they have ended the onboarding new contacts automation. And then we go to, should go here. And then we check again with an if else. Okay, has this person not entered our invite for my free course? Or has this person not entered the automation free email course? So is this person, like, did they not get an invitation yet? And are they also not inside the free email course already anyway? Now, if that's both not the case, because it's set to end, so you do not want to send it to or, because then maybe if someone is not in this, but is in this, then it will still start. So you want to make sure it's set to end. Then we click add, and then the person will get invited for a free course. Then we wait until they ended the free course. Then we ended, waited again, basically. And then we are going to check, okay, is this person not currently inside our evergreen newsletter? Now, if yes, the person is not in it, then we start our evergreen newsletter. Now, then we go to, and then I will check, okay, did this person already get my evergreen promotion? Now, if yes, we just go here into the 100-year wait in case I will ever add something. And if the person did not get the evergreen promotion, then they go into the evergreen discount promotion when they reach a certain lead score for up to 2 months. And otherwise, it will also just start right away. So lots of different possibilities with the if else. I think it's like a really cool feature, and you can use it to make your automations so much smarter. So I really hope that this gave you like a little overview of what's possible. Now, the next tutorial is also really cool. It's a little bit similar to this one because it's about ActiveCampaign goals. And it's also like a really cool feature to make your automation smarter. And when you see the tutorial, you will see that the if else and goals work really well together. Now, if you enjoy this tutorial, give it a little thumbs up. That would help me a lot. And if you want to see more tutorials like this, then be sure to subscribe.